Deputy Ruth Coppinger.
Thank you, Ciarán Corla. Taoiseach, the world awoke this morning to learn that Donald Trump has been elected as the President of the United States of America. And Taoiseach, last year you said that when you did meet Donald Trump face to face, you would tell him that he had racist views and that he was a racist. So Taoiseach, I was just wondering, could you give us an idea of when you think that will happen? Because from what I'm hearing today, the leaders of the three biggest parties in this Parliament are sending congratulations to Donald Trump, when actually all three of them raised huge problems with things that he has said in very recent past. Bertie Ahern is on the radio telling us we should now have a love-in with a man who is a racist, a misogynist, a homophobe, and many other things besides. Now, Taoiseach, I'd ask you, rather than sending congratulations to Donald Trump, that this Parliament and the people of this country would prefer if we sent sympathy and support to every single person of colour, every immigrant, every LGBT person, every Muslim, and of course every woman in America who is in danger of Trump acting out some of his policies. And Taoiseach, would you, agree that the best support we can give is to people to ensure that he doesn't act out on those? But he's elected now. He's not suddenly going to change. But Taoiseach, more in-depth analysis of this will obviously take place when the results are fully analysed. But it does speak volumes, really, about the neoliberal policies that have alienated so many millions of people in America over the last few years, the richest country in the world. Policies quite similar to your own, Taoiseach, in that the Wall Street barons were bailed out and rescued, are now enjoying the fruits of the recovery in America. The 20 richest people in America now have the same wealth as the bottom half of American society. And how under Obama and the Democrats, income inequality has actually grown four times faster than it did under Bush. And isn't it a totally dysfunctional capitalist electoral and economic system that puts a choice in front of the American people of either a billionaire developer or a creature of Wall Street? And that inequality that I spoke of, Taoiseach, could never be tapped by a candidate like Hillary Clinton. A candidate who represents Walmart with their food banks for their own workers, who supports fracking and refused to stand with the Indigenous people in Standing Rock, and who publicly rejoiced when bombs dropped on Libya and drones dropped on Pakistan. So, Taoiseach, could you tell us when you will be true to what you said about Donald Trump before the election?
Thank you, Deputy Coppinger. Taoiseach.
Thanks, Deputy Coppinger. Well, first of all, the people in the United States made a very democratic decision, and by their votes at the ballot box, they gave both the popular vote and the college vote from the states to Donald Trump to elect him as president-elect. I recall a comment made here in the Dáil when I think it was Deputy Boyd Barrett asked me if I would agree that comments made in the heat of battle in a primary election by the president-elect, I think before he was nominated formally as a candidate, were racist and dangerous, and I said yes in respect of those comments. I listened very carefully to the president-elect this morning, and the first thing he said was that it's now time to heal wounds, it's now time to build partnerships, and it's now time to work constructively with the people of the United States, all the people of the United States, and every other country and peoples that want to work with them. I have difference of opinion with you, but in the democratic sense, I was happy to congratulate you when the same democracy elected you and returned to this House to allow you to say what you're just talking about now. And that's absolutely right, and I don't have any problem with that. All of the good stuff, as you call it, doesn't come from just from that side. I mean, I don't know, Deputy McLaughlin is here. He's put an end single-handedly to fracking in this country for quite a long time, I would think. So maybe you should congratulate him in that regard. I'm very happy that the government will work with the new administration when appointed by the president-elect. pointed out to Deputy Adams in respect of his valid question about the peace process, about Northern Ireland, about undocumented Irish, about immigration, and the many other social, political, economic, job opportunities, situations that arise between Ireland and the United States, that we work very closely with the administration in that regard. So I'd be happy to deal with the President in a very constructive way, as he has announced to the world, that his administration will work to heal the wounds in America, will work to have the American people unite in their country's development, and he wants to form partnerships with like-minded countries to work in the interests of opportunities for everybody.
Taoiseach, Deputy Coppinger, you have a minute.
Taoiseach, what's become clear from this election is the burning need to break the two-party system in the US, which clearly offers no alternative to the millions of Americans who have suffered in the recession. And wouldn't it have been much better, Taoiseach, if the anger and discontent that's clearly evident in this result was reflected not in a right-wing demagogue and right-wing populist like Donald Trump, but in somebody like Bernie Sanders, who, if he hadn't been stopped and rigged by the Democrat primaries, and should have gone independent, and we may have had a different result today. But Taoiseach, I just wanted to say something about who we should be building bridges with in America right now. It's not Donald Trump, who hasn't changed and won't change. It is with those who are now in danger of potential attack from his election, from the abuse that he has legitimised, the racism and the misogyny as well. We need to send a message of support to all of those people, but also we need to urgently build a powerful anti-establishment alternative to cut across the hatred and division that Trump represents, to have a new alternative not tied to the Democrats that's corporate and pro-war, but that is a real party for the 99%. And I hope that people will organise in America right now to stop Trump should he take action.
Taoiseach, a minute to conclude.
As I said, this is a democratic decision of the American people who voted at the ballot box for in the election, and they've chosen President-elect Trump to be their 45th president. Obviously, there isn't any point in assessing what might have been. They've spoken. They've spoken very clearly. They've given him. The popular vote by a clear majority and the collegiate vote by a clear majority. So there isn't any point in wondering what might be a different result. Democracy, as you're aware, often throws up unexpected results like Brexit. All of the pundits, all of the commentators, all of the polls, all of the indicators said that the result would not be as has turned out, that the assumption by the vast majority of people was that Hillary Clinton would be elected as president. That's not now the case. And so democracy requires responsibility brings realism. And I'm quite sure that the president-elect, following through on his own words, will work with his new administration to do the rebuilding and the forming of partnerships and the creating of opportunities that he's spoken about, not just in America, but across the world. Because, as I said in this House before, the decision today is of global consequence, and this government, for one, together with members of the House, will work with the administration in the closest way that we can.
Thank you, Taoiseach, and that concludes the leader's questions.